Herkese merhaba, ben Tan Basket'ten Can Keder ve bugün özel bir röportaj için Maccabi Tel Aviv gardı Morisco ile beraberiz. Yarınki Barcelona Lasta maçı öncesi bize vakit ayırdığı için ona teşekkür ediyoruz.
Merhaba.
Okay, let's start. So, you're new for the EuroLeague. What are your first impressions about the EuroLeague?
It's a competitive league. I've noticed that all the teams are competitive. Have some talented players out here. Very talented players out here in the EuroLeague. I appreciate the fans, going to different countries, seeing the team pride that all the fans have in their team. I can appreciate that, and I appreciate all the fan love so far.
How was the personal adjustment for you guys being? Because I've seen your blog on the EuroLeague website. And you've been talking about the rules, the game style, the pace of the game.
Pace of the game is slower than NBA. It's more of a half-court dominant league. Multiple passes in the offense. The rules are a little different. Some of the rules, some of the fouls. What's an intentional foul, what's not an intentional foul. Not being able to call a timeout as a player.
Yeah.
That's the biggest adjustment as a point guard. You always, in the NBA, call a timeout, you control more here. Only the coaches can call a timeout. So just some small rules changes. But overall, though, I believe that I'm adjusting well. My teammates and my coaches do a good job helping me, understand some of the minor rules.
The first step for the traveling violation, that change of the rule.
That helped me because that's the way it is in the NBA. You can get that what they call zero step. I'm glad I didn't have to adjust it to that.
But have you had any friends in the EuroLeague before coming here to Maccabi before signing the contract? Have you asked them anything?
I asked a couple guys about EuroLeague. They had nothing but good things to say. Beautiful countries, the culture. Like I said, seeing different type of fans. Definitely, yes, very, very passionate.
Compared to the NBA.
Very, very passionate.
A lot of difference.
So, I definitely had a good understanding of kind of what to expect, so I think that made my transition a lot easier.
And how's your life in Tel Aviv apart from basketball? You do a lot of Europe trips too.
Life in Tel Aviv is nice. You got the beach, great food, fresh seafood off the Mediterranean.
Like in Florida, right?
Yeah, very similar to Florida. Very similar to Florida. So I enjoy it. Restaurants, man. There's so many different good restaurants. I'm a foodie. I like to eat. So
I've seen you talk about the sushi, fried sushi.
Oh man, they have a lot of food, man. Good steak, good like you said, sushi, good kebab, shrimp, pasta. They got salad. I mean, they got everything. So
you should have a lot of time to explore everything.
I definitely have a lot of time to explore the restaurants.
Uh-huh. And I'm gonna be asking you about your season at Miami. How would you describe your four seasons? A lot of successful moments.
Oh man, it was a blessing, playing in Miami, playing on a team like that. I was able to learn how to be the ultimate professional, playing with legendary players.
The big three, basically.
More than the big three.
All the scorers.
I mean, you got Ray Allen, you got Juwan Howard, you got LeBron, D-Wade, you got Chris Bosh. Mike Miller, you have a lot of talented guys, very successful professionals. So I was able to learn from the best.
And after you got traded, I've seen the interview with Coach Spoelstra. He said it was a very tough moment for him. And how was it for you, after those years, leave Miami and go to Milwaukee?
It's always tough when you leave somewhere that you're comfortable. It's always tough, especially. At a moment's notice like that, it's always tough. But it's part of the business. I always knew that was part of the business. You never hope that it happens to you, but it does. It happens to a lot of players. So, I packed my things, talked to my family, and took what I learned in Miami, took it to New Orleans.
And the weather might have changed a little.
The weather changed a lot. It was still warm, though, but it's not as tropical.
It's not like Ohio.
No. New Orleans is not like Ohio. The South is nothing like Ohio.
Okay. I've seen that you have a Norris Cole Foundation. What can you tell us about that?
The Norris Cole Foundation is about helping inner city youth from Dayton, Ohio, where I'm from. The focus is to help build community service, leadership, mentoring, and also health and well-being. As a kid growing up, I was always into sports, so I was healthy. I was strong academically, and I was always active in my community. So I wanted my foundation to represent that, to help the youth, to help the next generation.
Okay. And since you're from Ohio and you went to Cleveland State University, are you supporting the Cavs in the NBA?
I support Maccabi.
Right now, I support Maccabi. Okay. And also, I want to ask you something else. Your mother was an accountant, and your father was a mathematician.
Oh man, you did some real research.
I did some research, yeah. And you had great at high school, straight A's. And basketball was not your priority.
No, not at first. I mean, I played multiple sports. I played basketball, football, American football, baseball, and the track, long jump. So, I played multiple sports. I didn't know which one I wanted to do in college yet until my senior year when I chose basketball. But sports was just a part of my life. Academics, church, community, that was the main thing. And then sports was just extra.
Our last question is, where does your nickname come from, Coltrane?
Coltrane, that's only one of my nicknames, bro.
Yeah,
Coltrane was just a nickname they gave me in Miami. One of my mini nicknames in Miami. I had the flat top, so that was my main nickname, the flat top.
Okay.
And then once I cut that off, I have my brand called Cold Blooded, so everybody called me Cold Blooded.
You got enough t-shirts of Cold Blooded.
Yeah, Cold Blooded, Cold World. Nobody out here calls me Coltrane. Everybody out here calls me Cold Blooded.
Cold Blooded.
Yeah.
Okay. Well, thanks a lot for your time.
Thank you. Make sure y'all go visit coldblooded30.com to get merchandise. C-O-L-E, blooded, B-L-O-O-D-E-D-30.com.
Okay.